ಪ್ರದಂ ದೇವಂ ಕ್ಷಮಾಪೂರ್ಣಂ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ ವಂದೇ ಪರಮಹಂ ಸಾಖ್ಯಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ. ಜೀವನ್ ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಪ್ರದಂ ದೇವಂ ಕ್ಷಮಾಪೂರ್ಣಂ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ ವಂದೇ ಪರಮಹಂ ಸಾಖ್ಯಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ. ಆನಂದಾನುಭವಾಸ್ವಾದಂ ಸರ್ವರೋಗನಿವಾರಕಂ ವಂದೇ ಪಾಪವಿನಾಶಕ್ತಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ. ಆನಂದಾನುಭವಾಸ್ವಾದಂ ಸರ್ವರೋಗನಿವಾರಕಂ ವಂದೇ ಪಾಪವಿನಾಶಕ್ತಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ. ನಿತ್ಯಮುಕ್ತಂ ನಿರ್ವಿಕಲ್ಪಂ ಧ್ಯಾನಲೋಕಪ್ರದೀಪಕಂ.
ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ನಮ್ಮ ಯುಗದ ಒಬ್ಬ ಅಭೂತಪೂರ್ವ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಶಕ್ತಿ, ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಸಮಾಜದ ಆಂದೋಲನದ ಸಂಸ್ಥಾಪಕರು, ಆಧುನಿಕ ವೈದಿಕ ನವೋದಯದ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಅನ್ವೇಷಕ, ಪವಿತ್ರ ಊರಾದ ತಿರುವಣ್ಣಾಮಲೈನಲ್ಲಿ ಜನ್ಮ ತಾಳಿದ ಒಬ್ಬ ಯೋಗಿ, ಕೆಚ್ಚೆದೆಯ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಸಂಶೋಧಕ, ದೈವಶಕ್ತಿಯ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶಕ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ, ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಇಂದು ಪ್ರಾಚೀನ ರಹಸ್ಯಾರ್ಥ ಯೋಗ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನದ ಪಥದಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಲಕ್ಷಾಂತರ ನಿಪುಣರಿಗೆ ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿದಾಯಕರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕತೆಯ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನದ ಸಂಶೋಧನಾಕಾರ, ಆತ್ಮ ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ಕಾರ ತೋರುವ ಗುರುಗಳು, ಅವರ ವಿವೇಕದ ಸಂಪತ್ತು, ಅವರ ನಗುವಿನ ಆ ಸಂತಸ ಹಾಗೂ ಅವರ ಅದ್ವಿತೀಯ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಯ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಪ್ರತಿ ವರ್ಷ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಾದ್ಯಂತ ಸುಮಾರು 1 ಕೋಟಿ ಜನರೊಡನೆ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈಗ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಜೀವನ್ಮುಕ್ತಿಯ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಆನಂದಮಯ ಜೀವನಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಪರಿಹಾರಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತನಾಡಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮರೆಯಲಾರದ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಅನುಭವವನ್ನು ಕೈಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ, ಬನ್ನಿ.
ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ ಸರ್ವಧರ್ಮ ಪ್ರಣೇತಾರಂ ಸಚ್ಚಿದಾನಂದ ರೂಪಿಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಸನಾತನಂ ಪುಣ್ಯಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ. ವೇದ ವೇದಾಂತ ಸಂವೇದ್ಯಂ ದೇವದೇವಿ.
Krishna, with a smile, as though reminding him that he is not conscious of the truth, said these words to Arjuna, who was in sorrow, standing between the two armies. It's again a description, the verse which describes the scene. Here the word Bharata, through this word he is addressing Dhritarashtra. Dhritarashtra is from the Bharata Vamsa, Bharata's lineage. So he is saying, O Bharata, the indweller of all beings, Krishna, with a smile, said these words to Arjuna, who was in sorrow, standing between the two armies. It's a description of the whole scene. Only when you stand between the two armies, you can see both sides. If you are already on one side, you can't see both sides. Only if you are standing between the good and bad, you can see both. If you are already on the side of the good, you will not know all the bad things happens because of good. If you are already on the side of bad, you will not know all the good things happen by the bad. It's not that all the things of the good is always good, all the things of the bad is always bad. Only when you are standing in between, you can see both. Otherwise, naturally, the confusion is the quality of your decision. Please understand, if you are one side, the confusion takes over you. Any decision you make in confusion naturally ends in a huge suffering. Even in your life, don't stand at any side. Whenever there is a war, of course, your whole life is a war. at least 10 Mahabharata war happens in your 24 hours. Don't jump to conclusion, rush making decision. Small story. Husband calls home and the maid answers the phone. He says, "Can I speak to my wife?" She says, "No, she's upstairs in the bed with her boyfriend." He says, "Okay, go to the hall closet, take out my gun, go upstairs, shoot them both." Being a very loyal maid, she says, "Okay," and she picks up the phone after 5 minutes and says, "Okay, they are both dead. What should I do with the dead body?" He says, "Throw them in the pool and I'll take care of them when I get home." She says, "We don't have a pool." He asks, "Is this 555-1234? In hurry, sometimes you don't know. So don't make decisions in confusion and hurry. Stand between the good and bad. Only then you'll be able to see both. This loyal maid, from her side, what she thought as good, she went ahead. But good as a four leg, always look down whether all that four legs are on proper basement. Sometime the good may be standing, lifting two legs. In that two legs, maybe bad is sitting below the legs. It is not that all good are always good, all bad are always bad. Having little patience is really important. Till now, he was not expressing his avataric mission, the incarnationhood. First, he was silent, like a psychiatric doctor, listening. Then, he was uttering 2-3 words like a friend. Then, only when Arjuna said, "Sishyasteham, I am your disciple," he is up and is expressing his gurudom. Understand, when there is enough of disciplehood happening, disciplehood, I am using the word disciplehood, not enough disciples. There can be 10,000 disciples, but only one unit of disciplehood. There can be only one disciple, but 10,000 unit of disciplehood. Means the receptivity, disciplehood. When there is enough disciplehood, then lands an incarnation. If there are too many disciples but less disciplehood, an incarnation cannot express his purpose.
ಕಲ್ಪತರು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಜಾಗೃತಿಯ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಎಂದರೇನು? ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯನಲ್ಲೂ ಸುಪ್ತವಾಗಿ ಅಡಗಿರುವ ಅಸಾಧಾರಣ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯವೇ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ. ಒಬ್ಬ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಗುರುಗಳ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಯಿಂದ ಈ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಜಾಗೃತಗೊಳಿಸಬಹುದು. ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಜಾಗೃತಗೊಂಡರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದ ಪ್ರತಿ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳಲ್ಲೂ ಪರಿವರ್ತನೆ ತರುವ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಅದಕ್ಕಿದೆ. ಹಾಗೂ ಅದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ, ಸಂಪತ್ತು, ಯಶಸ್ಸು, ಸಂತೋಷಭರಿತ ಸಂಬಂಧಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಜ್ಞಾನೋದಯವನ್ನು ತಂದುಕೊಡುತ್ತದೆ. ಧ್ಯಾನ ಹಾಗೂ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಗಳ ಶಕ್ತಿಯ ಬಳಕೆಯನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಜಾಗೃತಿಯ ಒಂದು ಇಳುಕು ನೋಟವನ್ನು ಕಲ್ಪತರು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನುಭವಿಸಿ. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಭವಿಷ್ಯವನ್ನು ರೂಪಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಪ್ರತಿ ವಾರಾಂತ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಥಳ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಧ್ಯಾನಪೀಠ, ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ನಗರ, ಬಿಡದಿ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು.
See, for you to dance, you need a stage. For an incarnation to land and express the energy, you need real people filled with the disciplehood. Being a disciple, being a receiver, people who are completely in receptivity. Only enough of people who are filled with receptivity, even master expresses his gurudam, his great energy. So even for incarnation to express what he wants to express, proper disciples who are having the disciplehood, who are really in the mood of receiving are required. Basic truth. Gita comes out only when the disciples are ready to receive, not till then. So Bhagavan starts speaking. You are grieving for those for who are not to be grieved for. You are speaking words that are not fit to be uttered by the wise. The wise grieve neither for those whose life has departed nor for those whose life has not departed. What a words. Krishna just gives one statement. He is saying, you are grieving for those who are not to be grieved for. You are speaking words that are not fit to be uttered by the wise. The wise grieve neither for those whose life has departed nor for those whose life has not departed. He straight away comes to the truth about the life and death. He says, you are grieving for those who are not to be grieved for. See, you should not understand this word in ordinary sense, like you are grieving for your enemies who are ready to kill you. It's an ordinary meaning. But if you see the next words, Krishna is uttering, I don't see, he means, in ordinary sense, you are grieving for those who are not to be grieved for. And you are speaking words that are not fit to be uttered by the wise. The wise grieve neither for those whose life has departed nor for whose life has not departed. He is using a beautiful word. What do you mean by alive and dead? Let me define life. If your inner consciousness is awakened and goes on accumulating layers and layers of maturity, wisdom, by the rolling of time, it is life. Good or bad, layers of engrams makes you tired and old. Are you aging or growing? There are two different things. Aging, growing. If you are unconsciously, without any awareness, hitting time, any experience happens is accident. One guy goes to his boss and says, sir, now I am married, increase my salary. The employer says, factory is not responsible for the accidents happen outside. A patient goes to hospital with bleeding head. Nurse is getting the details from him. Your name? Patient gives the name, Santa. Nurse, birth date. Nurse is asking birth date. The patient gives the name, the date. And nurse asks, married? The patient says, no, car accident. Unconsciously, any encounter with the time is accident. Your very existence is accident. You are either already dead or waiting to die. That's it. There are millions of people who are already dead but not buried. These dead, not buried, they are only called bhutas. Krishna says, you are grieved for these people who are asuras, rakshasas. You are not to be grieved for these people.
ಓರ್ವ ಅವತಾರ ಪುರುಷರಿಂದ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನಕ್ಕೆ ದಿವ್ಯ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಬೇಕೇನು? ಪ್ರಸ್ತುತಪಡಿಸುತ್ತಿದ್ದೇವೆ, ಕರೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಪರಮಹಂಸರೊಡನೆ ಮುಖಾಮುಖಿ. ಇಡೀ ಜಗತ್ತಿಗೆ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಅಪೂರ್ವವಾದ ಹಾಗೂ ಅಸದೃಶವಾದ ಉಡುಗೊರೆಯನ್ನು ನೀಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ.
Got practically everything and too much for a phone call.
ಪ್ರತಿದಿನ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ನಡೆಯುವ ಸತ್ಸಂಗದ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳಿಗೂ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಉತ್ತರ ನೀಡಲು ಅವರು ಲಭ್ಯವಿರುವರು.
Now you ask anything you want in your life. Ask me any boon you want.
ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ 8 ಗಂಟೆಯ ನಂತರ +9180272799999 ಗೆ ಕರೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಸ್ವಾಮೀಜಿಯವರೊಂದಿಗೆ ಮಾತನಾಡುವ ಅದೃಷ್ಟ ನಿಮ್ಮದಾಗಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಹಾಗೂ ntv.nityananda.org ಇದರ ನೇರ ಪ್ರಸಾರವನ್ನು ವೀಕ್ಷಿಸಿ.
You need to at least stop the breathing, only then you can bury them. You can't directly bury. And so many millions of people, you will not even have time to bury. So you only have to give a mass, do a mass cremation. So you can't do mass cremation if they have the capacity to run. See, Krishna is not asking Arjuna to kill them. He says, they are all already dead, just help me to stop their running so that I can do the mass cremation. End of the Mahabharata, that's what was done. The mass cremation was done. They are all already dead. None of them had inner awakening except Bhishma. Only Bhishma is the person who had inner awakening, and he did not die in the war. He was put in deathbed, but he died only when he wanted. After the war was over, 56 days, he was lying on the deathbed in the war field. Only when the Uttarayana Punyakala started, he left the body. Krishna says, you are grieving for those who are not to be grieved for. And you are speaking words that are not fit to be uttered by the wise. There are many reasons to consider who is alive and who is dead. People who encounter the time with awareness, every moment, does not accumulate engrams. They accumulate maturity. Maximum time you are living inside your flesh and bones, see, you are becoming matured. Either you grow or you age. Both does not happen simultaneously. One couple lived together for 60 years without a single argument. Their secret is they shared the same hearing aid. Both can't hear the same time. Same way, either you age or you grow. Both can't happen at the same time. Living by aging or living by growing. People have their own reasons to live, their own reasons to love, their own reasons to be alive. A girl fell in love with a boy at second sight because at first sight she did not know he has a Rolls Royce. People have their own reason to fall in love. Live. The engram-based love, engram-based life is not living. Krishna starts with a beautiful statement. See, the statement is so precise, I am not able to expand on the statement. I am not able to even comment on the statement. I only have to just repeat. He's so clear. The wise grieve neither for those whose life has departed nor for those whose life has not departed. He is not even using the word dead, live. He is using the word life has departed or not departed. If you are growing, even death is life for you. Just a different part of your life. If you are aging, even life is a death for you. I know how many millions are dead but having big houses, tomb with a key. You can't say they have houses. Tomb with a key. See, look back, how many of your houses have almost become like a graveyard? silent. Tuck, tuck, tuck. Only those few steps, the late night coming and slowly sneaking into the bed. And morning, neither he is there nor she is bothered.
Because 2000 crore loss.
To reach at least 1 lakh people per day.
Life is a long examination whether you face it without engrams. Every moment you face it without engrams is a success. Every moment you face with engrams is a failure. It's a long examination. I read a one-liner about examination. 3 ways to write exam. Look up for inspiration. Look down for concentration. Look around for information. For life also it is same. Look up for inspiration. Look down for concentration. Look around for information. Life is a long examination where every moment you spend with awareness, you are winning the game. Every moment you spend with unawareness, you lose the game. You are grieving for those who are not to be grieved for, and you are speaking words that are not fit to be uttered by the wise. The wise grieve neither for those whose life has departed, nor for those whose life has not departed. Whether you are with the body or without the body, wise never grieve for anybody. If somebody is wise, they know man whose inner awakening has happened, even if he is without the body, he is only growing. Man whose inner awakening has not happened, even he is with the body, he is only aging. So they don't grieve for those who has departed, nor for those who life has not departed. I think it is such a strong line. Thousands of meanings can be given to this line. Thousands of interpretations can be done to this line. I think thousands of times this line has to be repeated again and again internally. This line has to be repeated again and again and again. In every situation of our life. So we understand every moment we spend with awareness is the moment you are growing. Start creating a diary for yourself. Today, how many hours I grew, how many hours I aged. If you count, every day morning 5 hours you grow during the sadhana. And after that, almost all the hours you age. Remember, every moment, are you growing or aging? Growing or aging? You are grieving for those who are not to be grieved for, and you are speaking words that are not fit to be uttered by the wise. The wise grieve neither for those whose life has departed, nor for those whose life has not departed. I leave you all with this one word, so that whole day you contemplate on this one word. Close your eyes and just sit with this one thought.